welcome to the chapter index number. In the previous class, we have solved examples on simple average of relatives. Okay. So in today's session, we are going to solve examples on simple aggregative price index number. Okay. So let us take the first example. Calculate simple aggregative price index number for the data given below. See, in the first column, items are given A, B, C, D and price of base year as well as current year. See, for this question, we have to find out simple aggregative price index number. Okay, so let us solve this example solution. The formula of simple aggregative price index number is given by, so P01 is equal to summation P1 divided by summation P0 into 100. So this means total of current year price divided by total of base year price into 100. So this means to find out the simple aggregative price index number, we want total of current year price as well as base year price. So these are base year price values. So this means P0, these are current year price values. So add these values. See, so first base year price means it is P0. The values are 25 plus 13 plus 15 plus 17. So this means summation P0 total is 70. Next, price of current year means it is denoted by small p1. So add these values, 30 plus 15 plus 17 plus 28 is equal to 90. So this means summation p1 is equal to 90. So now we got total of summation p0 is 70 and summation p1 is 90. Now you substitute these values. So therefore summation p1 is 90, summation p0 is 70 into 100. So this becomes 90 divided by 70 into 100 equals P01 is equal to 128.57. So simple aggregative price index number for this question is, the answer is 128.57. Let us solve the problems on weighted price index number. In the previous session, we solved examples on unweighted price index number. So now here we are going to solve examples on weighted price index number. So as you know, in the weighted price index numbers, we have two types of formulas. One is weighted price index numbers and weighted aggregative price index numbers. So let us solve the first example. I'll just read out the question. Calculate price index numbers for the following data using weighted arithmetic mean price relatives method. So first column, items are given wheat, rice, gram, pulses, and price of 2005 and 2010 is given. And the next row, there is a weight is given 4, 3, 2, 1. So observe the question. So here we are solving examples on weighted price index numbers. So this is, here for this question you have to apply weighted arithmetic mean. So solution, as you know, first you write the given things. Price of 2005 means, so this is base year P0. Price of 2010 means it is current year. So 2005 means base year price. So these are base year price, 15, 16, 5, 4. Price of 2010 means these are current year price. So 20, 22, 8, again 8. So this is weight. So weight is given 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay. So these are the given things. So as we know, the formula of weighted arithmetic mean price index number is given by P01 is equal to summation WP divided by summation W. So this means to find out the weighted arithmetic mean, we want capital P. So what is capital P? capital P means it is price relative. So first you have to find out the price relative, then you multiply with price relative into W. W means weights. So after multiplying W into P, you take the summation of WP, then we want total of summation W, weights. So already here weights are given, you have to add these values. Summation W is 10. Next, you have to find out price relative. As you know, price relative formula is current year price divided by base year price into 100. So P1 divided by P0 into 100, 20 divided by 15 into 100 is 133.3. Next, 22 divided by 16 into 100 is 137.5. 8 divided by 5 is 160. 8 divided by 4 into 100 is 200. So these are the price relatives. Okay, already W is given in the question. So we want summation WP. So this means next you have to multiply W into P. Okay, 4 into 133.3 is 533.2. 3 into 137.5 is 412.5. And 2 into 160 is 320. So 1 into 200 is 200. So after finding the WP values, we want summation of this. So after adding these values, summation WP is 1465.7. Summation WP is 1465.7. So now you substitute in the formula. So summation WP is 1465.7. Summation W is 10. So substitute here 10. So after solving this, P01 is equal to 146.57. So this means, so weighted arithmetic mean for this question is 146.57. So let us take the next example, that is in after weighted arithmetic mean, next is weighted geometric mean. So next example is weighted geometric mean. I'll just read out the question. Calculate price index numbers for the following data using weighted geometric mean price relatives method. The first column item is given wheat, rice, gram, pulses, and price of 2005 as well as price of 2010, and weight is given 4321. So okay, so here for this question you have to find out weighted geometric mean. Solution: first you write the given things. Price of 2005 means base year price, P0 values. Price of 2010 means these are current year values. Then weights is given, write down the weights. Okay, so then what is the formula of weighted geometric mean price index number? See here, the formula of weighted geometric mean index number is P01 is equal to anti-log of, into bracket of, summation W log of P divided by summation W. So it is very, very important. See the formula to find out the weighted geometric mean. So what we require? We want summation W log P. So this means first we have to find out the price relatives. After finding the price relatives, find out the log of P values. So next, after finding the log of P values, multiply with the W. Okay, then you take the summation W total. So weights is already given in the table. Summation W is 10. After finding the price relatives, as you know the price relatives, price relative means current year price divided by base year price. 20 divided by 15 into 100 is 133.3. 22 divided by 16 into 100 is 137.5. 8 divided by 5 into 100 is 160. 8 divided by 4 into 100 is 200. So these are the price relatives. So after finding the price relatives, we want log of P values. So this means first you have to find out the log value of this. So log of 133.3. So before finding the log value, first you see the digits. So how many digits are there here? There are 3 digits. So 3 minus 1 is 2, 2 point, and log of 13 under 3 is 1239. Log of 13 under 3 is 1239. And mean difference under 3 is 10. So this 10 you have to add with 1239 plus 10 is, the final answer is 1249. So this means log of 133.3 is 2.1249. Next, you have to find out the log of 137.5. So again, here digits are 3. 3 minus 1 is 2. Log of 13 under 7 is, log of 13 under 7 is 1367. Log 13 under 7 is 1367. And mean difference under 5 is 16. 16. So you have to add this 16 with 1367. 1367 plus 16 is 1383. So this means final answer of log of 137.5 is 2.1383. So next is log of 160. So log of 160, here digits are 3, 3 minus 1 is 2. Log of 16 under 0 is 0.2041. So next, 200, here digits are 3, 3 minus 1 is 2. Log of 20 under 0 is 3010. The final answer is log of 200 is 2.3010. So after finding the log of p values, we want, dear students, after finding the log of p values, so next step is, so you have to multiply with w into log of p values. So multiply, these are the w values, then log of p values. So multiply w with log of p values. So 4 into 2.1249 is 8.4996. 3 into 2.1383 is 6.4149. 2 into 2.2041 is 4.4082. And the last one is 1 into 2.3010 is 2.3010. So after finding the w into log of p values, you have to take the summation of this. So after adding these values, summation w log p is 21.6237. So now you substitute in the formula all the values. See here, summation w log p is 21.6237 divided by 10. So anti log of 21.6237 divided by 10 becomes, so the next answer is anti log of 2.1624. So after finding the anti log of this, so anti log of 2.1624 is, in the anti logarithm table, you have to see the logarithm of this. The final answer is anti log of 2.1624 is 145.3. So dear students, in the next class, we are going to solve some more examples on weighted index numbers. So, thank you.